So we often get the question about why we homeschool. And even if people aren't asking us explicitly that question, we always feel like we have to have an answer ready because it's such a countercultural thing to do. And also because when people find out we homeschool, they usually react to they react negatively to that revelation. And the reasons why we homeschool are so many that it's hard to actually give a succinct explanation. It's the accumulation of all of these different reasons. So I've been trying to come up with a more succinct or even singular reason to be able to explain it in something like a syllogism, even if I can. And I feel like I recently had a bit of a breakthrough. Before I get to that sort of singular reason, I want to give a bit of an explanation that sort of leads up to it. But the heart of it comes down to the fact that we as a society are so incoherent that we have set up this singular education system that so many of us have to fail, yet we still insist that we have a single education system, which is the impossible task that we have charged educators with. In order to explain why I think that, we have to start with defining some of our terms here. Like, for example, what is education? What does that mean? Because we can't talk about what is the best way to educate somebody if we don't know what we mean by education. Well, the formal definition of education is something like the facilitation of learning or the acquisition of knowledge, skills, beliefs, and habits. But if you ask me, that is far too narrow a definition for education because it implies that education is something that has to happen in a formal institutional setting. That's what this word facilitating implies in my mind. And it's also why we tend to think of people who are educated as someone who has successfully traversed the rigors of this formal institutional setting. But I've met people who have specialized college degrees who are fairly useless outside of their specialty. And I've met people who have no college education, but who have a broad range of knowledge and skills. And we as a society consider the former to be educated and the latter not to be educated, and then we streamline our opportunities to favor the former instead of the latter. And I have to say, that's some bullshit. Education doesn't begin when a child is 6 years old and they've been placed or enrolled in an institution. Think of all the things that they've learned up until that point. They've learned basic hygiene, language, motor skills, social decorum, and the basis for moral conduct. So a definition that I think shows an appreciation for that full scope of education is the transmission of culture. And in order to understand what that means, we have to define what culture means. Culture in this sense means a way of life. It's the knowledge, the technology, the science, the beliefs, the ethics, and probably most importantly, the religion or the cult, the worship, because cult is the root of culture that is expressed through a way of life. Every good civilization starts with a creed of beliefs, and then that creed of beliefs is incarnated into a way of life, and that's what a culture is. And if that civilization prospers, it would be an injustice not to transmit that prosperity to future generations. And this prosperity isn't just merely a prosperity of material goods, but it's the way of life that produced that prosperity and those material goods. Otherwise, that material prosperity will turn to ash in the hands of those future generations or those heirs. That's why we have education, to ensure that those future generations don't have to reinvent the wheel every single time, that they don't have to solve all the same problems that past generations have already figured out. And in order to educate future generations, you have to have a shared way of life and a shared culture. No civilization can survive the death of its culture. And this is where we get to the problem of education. Because modern Western civilization has no shared culture. We discarded it in favor of a new vision of cultural relativism, which is, by the way, a goal right out of the Marxist revolutionary playbook. In Mao's revolutionary China, for example, they had identified the four olds which had to be destroyed in order to instantiate their new cultural revolution. So in their case, the four olds were the habits, the customs, the beliefs, and the culture of their ancestors. Now that we have successfully abandoned the culture of our own ancestors, we call ourselves multicultural. But that isn't actually true. Anybody who wants to retain their culture will find that just by participating in a modern Western country like Canada, where I live, they will have their culture diluted just by being immersed in it. You see this with immigrants, for example. The first generation places a lot of emphasis on retaining and preserving their heritage and their culture. But by the second or third generation, they witness their descendants and their culture getting diluted into the basic cultural relativism that they live within. As a society, we do nothing to protect the multiple cultures that we supposedly celebrate with concepts like multiculturalism. We just wait for them to die in the pressure cooker of cultural assimilation. And so we have no shared culture. We have no shared way of life, no shared belief, no shared creed, no shared ethics, and certainly no shared religion. And if you try to retain or acquire some culture, you will find yourself under constant pressure for that culture to be diluted until you achieve some sort of thermal equilibrium with the surrounding soup of broader society. But here's where we as a society become completely incoherent in our intentions. We still insist on having a single education system. But if education is the transmission of culture, and we have no single culture, how do we transmit a single culture through a single education system? How do we agree about what is to be taught? Well, we either reduce the curriculum to some sort of lifeless residue of our former culture so that it doesn't contrast with anybody else's culture, or some kind of a strongman, like a political party or a political leader, will force a new vision of a way of life through our education system. And both of those things have been happening. So to summarize, education is the transmission of culture, yet we have no single shared culture to transmit. But we still insist on unifying our education system with one approved curriculum as if we did have a single vision for a way of life. But if you're someone like me who wants to retain a creed and a culture and whose family is heavily invested in that culture, to commit the formation of my children to an education system that will only transmit cultural relativism to them at best, or at worst a competing culture, that would be pretty stupid. Because just like those first generation immigrants who try to retain their culture only to watch it dissipate in future generations, I cannot hope to transmit the beliefs and the creed and the culture that is so important to me while a sophisticated institution tries to ingrain a competing culture into my children for 6 to 8 hours a day. And because my wife and I are so enthusiastic about the merits of the creed and the culture that we've adopted, and in the hopes that our children will have the best chance of adopting that culture, we've decided to educate them ourselves. And if that's important to you, I would strongly encourage you to consider doing so as well. Thanks for watching. The reason I can continue making content like this is because of the generous support of my viewers. If you feel called to support this work, then consider joining the Reinforcements, which is my online community. There are multiple tiers, including free access for those who can't help financially but still want to join. You can join up at www.brianholdsworth.ca. Certain levels will also get a free gift basket from Glory and Shine, who is a family-owned Catholic bath and body products company whose beard balm I'm wearing right now. It's like aromatherapy on your face. Even if you don't join, they make amazing products, so check them out at gloryandshine.com. And don't forget to like and subscribe. You don't have to agree with everything I said to get value out of these kinds of conversations. So be sure to subscribe to be edified or challenged. There's value in both. Thanks for watching.